Hello everyone. Now in this video lecture, we'll be learning the underpinning or underpinning technique. Underpinning is nothing but to strengthen the existing foundation or the process for strengthening of the existing foundation. Underpinning is the method for repair and strengthening of a building foundations. There are situations where failure in the foundation or footing happens unexpectedly after the completion of whole structure, both sub and superstructure. Under such an emergency situation, a remedial method has to be suggested to regain the structural ability or structural stability. The method of underpinning helps to strengthen the foundation of an existing building or any other infrastructure. This involves installation of permanent or temporary support to an already held foundation so that additional depth and bearing capacity is achieved. Now in this picture, you can see how underpinning is done for the existing structure. Beneath the ground beam, excavation is done. Temporary supports are being provided. You can see these temporary jacks that are being provided. And after the excavation, concreting is done. That is nothing but underpinning, so that the foundation can be strengthened. This is the another image you can see. For the existing structure, excavation is done, and now in this excavation, concrete will be poured or new foundation will be casted so that the bearing capacity could be increased. Now, types of work for selection of underpinning method. Next, conversion work. When the structure has to be converted from one function to another, which requires stronger foundation compared to the existing. That is nothing but when load on the existing structure is to be increased or the functioning of the existing structure is to be transferred from one function to another. Next, protection works. The following problems of a building has to undergo protection work. The existing foundation is not strong or stable, then at this time underpinning method is adopted. Nearby excavation would affect the soil that supports existing footing. Stabilization of the foundation soil to resist against the natural calamities, such as if flood condition occur, erosion of soil takes place or the landslide may occur, and in this case soil bearing capacity is reduced or the soil beneath the foundation may get drained off. Hence, requirement of basement below an already existing structure, underpinning method is adopted. Remedial works. When there is mistake in initial foundation design caused subsidence of the structure, work on the present structure then building a new one. This means when differential settlement or the settlement of structure takes place due to inefficient foundation or defect in construction technique, then at this place, rather than constructing entire new structure, existing structure foundation can be strengthened by using underpinning technique. Now, structural conditions which requires underpinning. There are many reasons that make an engineer to suggest underpinning method for stabilization of the substructure, such as the degradation of timber piles. The degradation of timber piles used as foundation for normal buildings would cause settlements. Hence, this degradation of structure is due to water or water table fluctuations. Rise and lowering of the water table can cause a decrease of bearing capacity of soil, making the structure to settle, that is settlement of entire structure. Structures that are built over soil with a bearing capacity not suitable for the structure would cause settlement. Now in this file, you can see how underpinning is being done. For this existing structure, excavation is done using this drilling equipment. You can see. And after the excavation is done, concrete will be poured here. In this figure, you can see how underpinning is being done. When soil erosion takes place or landslide takes place or the soil beneath the foundation gets drained off, then temporary supports are provided for the existing structure, and after this, concreting will be done beneath this so that the existing foundations of the structures could be strengthened. Now, in the upcoming video, you will see the underpinning technique. Now let us see the example of underpinning technique which comes under remedial work or the maintenance of existing structure is to be carried out. Now in this video you can see the underpinning technique for the maintenance of existing structure is being adopted. Here jack tightening is done. Jacks are being provided a suitable interval for entire structure beneath the plinth beams. Here, underpinning technique for the maintenance of existing structure is adopted so as to increase the plinth height by 3.5 feet. You can see all the internal parts of the structure where jacks are being provided. You can see wooden block provided beneath and above the jack so that firm support or which acts as firm support during jacking. Purpose here of underpinning technique adoption is to increase the plinth height by 3.5 feet. Later on, concreting will be done beneath these plinth beams. So that the existing structure can be strengthened with good foundation. And our objective to increase the plinth height by 3.5 feet could be achieved. Here you can see all the jacks are being provided. This is the temporary brickwork done. Here jack tightening is to be carried out. You can see internal portion of the structure. Now, in this way, we have seen the example of underpinning technique. Thank you.